So the first memory phrase is six liberalizations, and they are in trade, investment, transit, in personnel, goods, data, as well as money. So the keywords of free and open actually appeared over 150 times in the original script of the master plan. So Hainan officials are obviously going to enlarge these advantages. The focus of future policies will be on achieving a zero tariff situation in trading goods, as well as a relaxed restrictions on trading services. And the second memory phrase is one modernized industrial system, which with Hainan's own characteristics at the center, namely tourism, service industry, as well as high-tech industries. And the Hainan officials say for foreign companies with heavy investment in these sectors, they will be considered for a huge amount of tax exemption. And lastly, the four institutional conveniences are on taxation, social governance, rule of law, as well as prevention and control of financial risks. But Hainan province does not only has its own economic and financial advantages, it also has a geological adjacency to China's Greater Bay Area, as well as with ASEAN countries. So that raises a question of whether Hainan is going to replace the city of Hong Kong as China's new financial and economic hub. And to answer that, officials have this to say.
Hainan will give priority to trade and investment, will focus on developing tourism, modern services and high-tech industries, so that the free trade port can have its unique strengths and we can inject vitality into the development of global free trade ports. In this sense, the position of Hainan and Hong Kong will be different. Their priority areas are different as well, so they are complementary rather than competitive. Hainan will not pose a severe challenge or threat to Hong Kong.